1996 was the Patriots' year. They tried that one. How about the Steelers are coming? The Steelers are coming, and their orders were, don't fire until you see the whites in their eyes. Unless, of course, you can't see their eyes at all. Then fire as soon as you come out of the locker room. Here we go from Foxborough, where you could barely see. Brings back memories. Wasn't as bad as this one, the 88 Fog Bowl between the Bears and Eagles, but it was that sort of day, a Van Morrison into the Mystic day. And in the very first possession, right away, first play, Drew Bledsoe, Terry Glenn, down to the one-yard line, Joe, they win at Woodson right away.
Well, Rod Woodson, don't peak run. Oh, see what happens when you peak? People run by you. They went right at the heart of the line early.
What about that? On one play, they're down to the one. On the next play, they're up 7-0. Curtis, my favorite, Martin, touchdown, 7-0. Paul Revere riding in a frenzy. Next Patriot possession. We told you on countdown, watch out for key fires. The little swing pass. And look at Big William Roberts lead the way. Fires is gone. 34 yards, 14-0, E-Man.
Yeah, great blocking out front also by Todd Rucci, number 71. Gets a block on Darren Perry and Rod Woodson to screen Byers to the end zone.
While Bill Cowher tried to establish the running game with the bus, Jerome Bettis, Tommy, but they're already down 14-0.
Yeah, Bettis getting stuffed right here by Chris Slade and Mark Wheeler, and then Bettis stuffed again by Wheeler and Collins. So nothing for him. They got him running a little bit east and west.
And here's the option for Cordell Stewart, but boy, the Patriots played the run better than they have all year. So second quarter, fourth and four, the Steelers playing down 14-0, and little trickery. They snap it to the up man. Fred McAfee goes 8 yards for the first down, Joe, but then here come the Patriots rush.
And here they come. Tom Zach's back. He's looking. All he can see is Chad Eaton in your face one time. Next time, all right, let me go back, try it again. This time, Chris Slade. Oh, my goodness, they're coming from everywhere.
Slade says, Mama, we're all crazy now. The next Patriots possession. Curtis, my favorite, Martin. An innocuous little play, but he could go all the way. 78 yards, one if I land, two if I see, 21-0, Patriots.
Yeah, as we take a look at the replay, you're going to see the things that make Curtis Martin great. Great vision, the cutback lane right there, the last guy with a shot at him, Carnell Lake. He gives Carnell Lake a shake of the leg, and he's off to the end zone.
Well, it wasn't really Tom Zach's fault. They weren't playing defense, but now they need points. So, Joe, it's Cordell Stewart, but the throw, not the way to go.
No, here comes Willie Clay. Bang, one into the ground. All right, let's try it again. Didn't work that time. Ted Johnson, Dwayne Saab, no more. Sorry, Cordell. Slash me. Ha! The third time, why not? Let me see if I can throw one out here. I don't think so. That one's into the ground, low and hard.
He's been such a good player, but today, slash was slush. 0 for 10 for 0, obviously. Four carries for just a few yards. Second quarter. Willie Williams, though, makes a nice interception of a kind of a crazy pass thrown by Drew Bledsoe. So could the Steelers get into it at the end of the half? Tom Zach back in. Andre Hastings screen for 7 yards. On fourth and three, down 21-0. They figure we need a lot of points. They go for it. Tom Zach to Fred McAfee. But Teddy Bruschi brings it down, and already in the stands, they were firing down a few Bruschis. 21-0 Patriots. Third quarter, Bledsoe, but it's right to Chad Brown. So maybe the Steelers have some light. Tom Zach back in, and he'll pump and look for Andre Hastings. A fine catch, 23 yards. Later in the drive on third and 10, here's Cordell in there as a halfback, and Harry Houdini, nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. He gets 5 yards, but not a first down. This time, let's get on the board. Says the Steelers, Norm Johnson, field goal, 29 yards, good, 21-3 Patriots. But Tom Zach and the Steelers offense never could get it going. They knew they had to make something happen. And this is Lawyers in Love Malloy. Double coverage makes the pick on Tom Zach. And then the next possession in the fourth quarter, it was sealed. Curtis Martin, a little fake. Oh, what a cut at the 22, and he's gone. Three touchdowns, 166 yards for Martin. He's ecstatic. This look says it all. These were not the Steelers that Bill Cowher has grown to love. These were the Patriots that Bill Parcells has seen on occasion. The Sunday night game against San Diego, a couple other times they've looked like world beaters. Today they were world beaters. They knock out the defending AFC champs by the count of 28-3. First six plays of the game included a 34, 53, and a 78-yard gain. They didn't even take steal a penalty because they gained more yards than the penalties would have given. Keith Byers was signed in the middle of the year by the Patriots. Good move by both.
Pittsburgh, you know, they're a great team. They're the defending AFC champions. But, you know, they got sort of a bully-type mentality. And when you get a bully in your backyard, you got to hit him in the mouth first to let him know you're not going to back down. And that's how you got to handle a bully, and that's exactly what we did.
They did a lot of blitzing and things like that. You know, they really they did some good things in terms of blitzing us and keeping us off balance.
We can't take nothing away from them. If they wasn't a good team, they wouldn't be in the playoffs. They wouldn't have went to the Super Bowl last year. But what people don't understand, that's last year. It's a new year. You know, you gotta prove yourself every year. You gotta prove yourself every year. And all the talk in the world, all the interviews in the world, all the shows, all the ESPN up close, all that stuff don't matter. What matters is what the score is after the game.
The teams that have had trouble against Pittsburgh acted like they were a little bit confused, didn't know where they were going. We knew exactly what we were doing coming into the game, and because of that, our guys were able to be aggressive in getting their job done.
Boy, Drew sounds so low-key, doesn't he? Well, I'll tell you what, he was not low-key, guys, because New England went for the jugular right away, Tom, and Bledsoe was on right away.
Well, we just heard Drew talking about confidence, and I think early on this morning we talked on Countdown about the confidence and the timing with which he would have to throw the ball early on. He did just that. He had a slow second quarter late, but early on in this football game, very sharp. You watch him deliver the ball on time. You watch him stepping through into his throws with confidence. We're going to even see him give a little movement as he takes the next snap. He comes just slightly to his right, but again, delivering the ball where his receivers can catch it and make some ground, giving them a chance quickly to get upfield and make some yardage. And I think we also have to credit Bill Parcells. He knew that the fog was going to roll in. He didn't want that bus to roll out of that Steeler garage. He did a lot of things early on with this offense.
Well, the bus had a flat tire. I think that's the one thing you have to take into consideration as well. You've got Jerome Bettis out there who really wasn't at 100%, and that's how the Pittsburgh Steelers got into the playoffs, because Jerome was 100%. They're a one-dimensional football team. They can't throw the football effectively. Cordell Stewart, 0 for 10. Mike Tomczak, 16 for 29. You can't go 16 for 39 in a football game and expect to win it, especially when the other team has the ability to put a lot of points on the board in a hurry like New England did.
It looked like Pittsburgh was demoralized early. I mean, obviously they were, but defensively, this was not the Steeler team that we had seen.
Tired, Boom.
Well, they were tired, and they already knew that we were down 14-0, and Jerome Bettis at the bus was a transit strike. They couldn't run. And give New England defense credit. They said that they've been coming on lately. Well, they were coming on gangbusters, and now they get to host the AFC Championship game. How about that? Well, the New England Patriots rolled it up on the Steelers, which means the Steelers allowed more than 17 points. When that happens, they're 0-7. 17 or less, they win those games. As you say, Joe, they're one type of team. Usually it's good enough to get you to the AFC Championship game. It's not good enough this year. Congratulations to the Patriots. We'll talk about the AFC title game later in the show.
Inside the Numbers is brought to you by Visa, the preferred card of the NFL. It's everywhere you want to be.
And when we return, well, the AFC champs were out. What about the Super Bowl champs? Certainly they couldn't fall on the same day as the Steelers. Or could they? We'll be back.
But your bank has a better way, the Visa check card. And if your ATM card has a Visa logo on it, you've got one. It automatically deducts from your checking account everywhere Visa's accepted.
You're despicable.
Visa check card works just like a check, only better.
What a maroon.
Soon, you won't recognize me, because my New Year's resolution is to regrow my hair with Rogaine. Because now, you can get this new Rogaine starter kit, a 4-month supply for half price. So go for it, and get a real head start on the new year.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did you want this?
America's favorite fries, McDonald's. Go get them.
What better place than an NFL game to ask people about the taste of Wheaties, the breakfast of champions?
Well, you can really taste the whole wheat.
I like it. I like the taste. They've got a toastable wheat flavor.
Can I have another bite?
These have got a crunchy, toasted taste to them.
I'm going to run home and buy a box of Wheaties for me and my kids.
Try the championship taste of toasted whole wheat Wheaties. Collect 5 Wheaties Super Bowl boxes featuring actual Super Bowl footage. But hurry, they're really moving. Better eat Wheaties.
Taste. That's my line.
Tim Cowboys.
Or would it be, how about them Panthers? We'll be back.
The Lombardi Trophy is the symbol of excellence in professional football. And the Super Bowl coin is the official symbol of excellence in sports collectibles. That's why the National Football League commissioned Balfour, maker of Super Bowl championship rings, to craft the official game coin for Super Bowl 31. Now, you can reserve a limited edition bronze replica of this championship medallion for yourself or as the perfect gift for just $29.95. Each coin is minted with Balfour Luminous Bronze, and each coin is individually numbered and authenticated while honoring the conference champions. The memory of Super Bowl 31 may fade, but this limited edition sports collectible will last for generations. All advance reservations will receive a free collector's display case. But this is a limited edition. These molds will be destroyed after minting. Call now to order.
To order, call 1-800-214-4300. That's 1-800-214-4300.
Security's always been an issue for us here, like any other company. But since we've grown, it's gotten tighter. We're not proud of it. We don't brag about it. But you never know who the hell's going to walk through the door.
I got a delivery.
Can I see some ID, please?
Well, my hands are kind of full right now.
He said he wanted to see some ID, sorry.
You don't know how crazy people can be out there. It's dangerous.
Next time, have some ID.
Hey, Rob.
Hey, Coach.
You can't be too careful.